everybody! I am Nico D, so today I'm gonna talk about the advantages of using an SBC versus an x86 computer. So there are many advantages, and you all know that I use SBCs a lot. There's even one on here that you cannot see. You see? So here's an SBC. So I use SBCs a lot, I love SBCs a lot, but they have got a very big advantage compared to computers, compared to PCs, normal PCs, x86 PCs. So these things, they consume very little. So these use ARM socks. ARM socks do not need a lot of power, so they don't consume much. That is a big advantage for me. I have now been using SBCs as my main computers for 6 months, for a little more than 6 months. And even that small period, you can already see it on my electrical bill. So my electrical bill has gone down, of course. I can't show you it if I know where it is. Here it is. So this is my electrical bill. So this was 2018, so we have to compare 2018 with 2019. 2017 was very low because I was on vacation for 2 months in that year, so for 2 months I didn't spend anything. 2018 was a normal year. 2019 was also a normal year where I was at home the whole year, only one vacation, of course. But the difference is rather big. So in 2018, I have spent 2017 kilowatt hours. So that is quite a lot. And now 2019, for 6 months not using my PC. I have turned on my PC a few times, but my PC only goes on when I need it right now. Like, for instance, it used to be that my PC was on 24/7, even during the night I slept with the noise of my PC. So my PC did make a lot of noise, it did consume a lot of energy, but now I only have got my SBCs, so my NanoPi M4 does my main desktop jobs. It is also on 24/7, but it consumes less than 5 watts, while my computer consumes so much more. In use, a normal computer can consume more than 100 watts, while my SBCs cannot consume more than 10 watts, for example. So that is a magnitude of 10. That is so large. So why would you not use an SBC instead of an x86 PC is my question. There is a simple answer, of course. Simplicity is the reason number one. Simplicity is easy to work with an x86 PC. Everything has been made for you. You pay for everything. So that is why it has been made for you. With SBCs, you don't have to pay for software, but the software isn't finished yet. You have to do a lot yourself to make it work as you want it. So the difference is, have you got the time to put into it? Have you got the money to put into it? If you don't have time, but you have the money, then you use a PC. If you have got the time, you don't have the money, then use an ARM computer. They are very good. The RK3399 has now become such a very good SBC. It can do all the tasks that my PC did. I watch YouTube on it, I watch movies on it, I surf the internet, I go on Facebook, I do whatever a normal PC does. But this just consumes less than 10 watts, while my PC would consume more than 100 watts. So I have saved 10% of my electrical bill. There is still a lot of my lights are no LED lights, so I can still improve a lot on that. So that's my next task. Look for LED lights, maybe make them myself and put them everywhere, because now I have got saving lamps, but they are not LED lamps. So I can get my bill lower, even lower, by using LED lamps. but I am already happy that I don't have to pay more again for my electrical bill. So thank you, single board computers. You all have saved me a lot of money. So it is a thing to think about. Another great thing for SBCs is, of course, they do not make any sound. If you do not need to use a fan, like for example my NanoPi M4 version 2 has got a great heatsink as a case. So the case is made from metal. I don't need a fan on it. So that is great. It doesn't make any noise. While my PC is such a terrible beast of noise, I could not record myself with all that noise. So it is awesome. SBCs are awesome. All use SBCs instead of a PC if you can. It will save the world a lot of trouble. That's something that I swear. Certainly a lot of computational power and even servers can be replaced by ARM. It would save the world a lot of energy and the world would have a smaller electrical bill. What could save the planet? So ARM can save the planet. ARM, go for it. So that's it for today. It was just a chatty chat. And maybe there will come some more. I don't know. We will see. So I have saved 10% of my electrical bill. And that is a good thing. Finally good news in this quarantine where there is not much to do. So that's it for today. I hope you all like my video. See you later. Bye.